Oh, what are we doing today, baby? Come on, what are we doing?
Jam sponge, coconut on the top, and pink custard.
School dinner's time, remember that dessert? See how we get on with it. Hey, what's the matter with you, baby? So what have we got today then? We're going to do a school dinners again. A lot of requests for the school dinners. A lot of you like the old 70s and 60s school dinners. I think you still had them in the 80s. Did we speak to someone recently?
No. My granddaughter, who is 4.
Little.
I made one last week. And she said, Nanny, we have this at school. So they're still doing it. And then she said her school ones were better than mine.
But I don't think they have the pink custard now, do we?
Yeah, she didn't understand.
God, we stink of onions, don't we? Can you smell that? We just had crackers. And I put some onions
cheese
on top.
And crackers.
Smelly cheese as well. And we've scoffed that, so I'm talking to her. And all I can smell is blinking onions. And
you should be able to smell it.
No, I can taste it as well. Yeah, I can smell it.
I love raw onion. Oh.
Yesterday she stunk of garlic. Unbelievable.
Garlic mushroom yesterday.
Garlic mushroom. Anyway, in other words, we digress. Right, so we're going to cook this school dinners, which is a dessert which I used to remember having when I was a teenager in the 70s.
I had them in primary school, not only when I was a teenager.
Yeah, in the 70s, I covered the...
You said teenager.
All right, baby. I'm wrong again, aren't I? In the 70s, then. How about that? I probably had it in the 60s, but I don't remember because I was a bit too young. I was about 8 or 9 or 10. I was born in the 60s, as you know, the first part of the 60s. So we probably did have it, but I don't remember it. And some of the best times you've had is when you've been at school, baby. Anyway, right, okay. So, right, steam sponge. No, it's not steam sponge, is it? What is it?
Oh, no, I don't want to do no more steam for a while, please.
So, let's have the ingredients, baby, for our jam sponge with coconut in and also our
pink custard.
What we used to call pink custard. It wasn't actually pink custard. She's going to tell you what it is. Go through the ingredients, baby.
Right, we're going to have 6 ounces or 170 grams of margarine, 6 ounces or 170 grams of sugar, 6 ounces or 170 grams of self-raisin flour, 3 eggs, 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla extract, 100 grams or 3.5 ounces of desiccated coconut.
Right, that's going to make our sponge mix. So that's the first part. The second part is?
Jam for the topping and some desiccated coconut to put on the topping.
Just to sprinkle over the top.
Quite a bit. Later,
yeah, so just a little bit. We actually made our own jam. You've got your own strawberry jam here, haven't you?
Oh, yeah, homemade.
So that's another thing she's done as well.
Big clumps of strawberry in.
Right, and now we've got the pink custard, baby. Now, tell people it's not actually custard, is it?
It's blancmange.
Every time we type in how to make pink custard into YouTube, all we get is some ingredients come up from a cosmetic company. And that's not what we was looking for. And I spoke to a school dinner lady, and she actually confirmed to me that the pink custard, what we used to think was custard, is actually pink blancmange.
That's you, Bernie.
Raspberry blancmange. Bernie, you know who
Auntie
you are.
Auntie Bernie.
She said she used to work in a school kitchen. And I said to her, do you know how to make pink custard? She said, it's not actually custard, it is actually blancmange. So there you go. The one we've got here is one called Pierce and Duff. So if you're looking to recreate in this packet here, we've got strawberry, raspberry, chocolate and vanilla. Obviously 4 different packets. We're only interested in the raspberry flavour. Apparently that works best. And you can also do it with a strawberry, but for that real effect, you want the raspberry flavour one. So that's what we're going to be using today. I never knew that pink custard was blancmange. That's been a mystery for years, hasn't it, baby?
Well, it's not really bothered me.
Because I'm as an adult, I wanted to recreate this, and we can only do it correctly to bring it to you. Right, what are we going to do first, baby?
It's a nice, easy one today. It's an all-in-one method.
Ooh!
So he gets to play while I put my little hand mixer
on. Oh, scratch my back, I haven't got an itch. No, that side.
Well, I'm not supposed to know.
Oh, lovely. Go on. Go on. Why do dogs do that when you scratch their back?
Right, go on.
Oh, that's lovely. Right, good part of this recipe is that you can literally throw everything in at once. So we're just whacking the ingredients all together and put it in. It's a one bowl wonder. Finishing off there with a little drop of vanilla extract there. You could use essence, but we prefer to use the vanilla extract. There's more of a flavour to it. Whack in the 3 eggs as well. And we're just going to beat everything together now until we get that creamy consistency what we're looking for. And this is the actual batter for our sponge mix. Lovely little Sharon there, making a lovely little job of this. You can do this by hand, but obviously if you've got technology, you might as well use it. Right, that's it. She's combined all them ingredients there, and she's also put the coconut in right from the start. So literally most of the stuff has gone in first time. And now I'm gonna get rid of these. Okay, baby, that's where we are now. I've done a little tidy up for you. And right, we've got all the main ingredients creamed now. And what's the next stage?
Pour it in the tin.
Right, and here we've got a lightly buttered dish, and she's also putting flour inside it just to help it not stick when we turn it out. What size is that dish?
I don't know.
Wait there. I see you measuring them, baby.
I don't think I've done it right.
Well, one, give us a clue. Come on, let's see how accurate you are.
4, 5, 6, maybe 7 inches.
7 by what? Just guess it, baby.
No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
She reckons it's 7 by 5. Let's see what it really is.
Is it?
No, it's 10 inches by 8. Never get her to frame.
I've done the actual inside, though.
So did I, baby.
You went from there to there, didn't you?
Never get her to frame a picture for you. Right, it's a 10 by 8 tin, so hopefully this mix is going to do a 10 by 8 tin. That's the quantities. Right, okay, baby, wait there.
Right, so we're just going to tip our bowl out into our baking tray, and we're going to level the mixture out as well as what we can with our spatula, making sure you fill it all and try and level it off and get into the corners.
Right, so that's our coconut sponge mix totally incorporated now in our 8x10 container. Where does this go, Honey Bunch?
Well, in the oven.
Going in the oven now. What's the temperature?
180 centigrade or gas mark 6 for 20 minutes.
In you go, Honey Bunch. She's having a go at me today. Right, okay then. Right, so while that's cooking, we're going to have a little clear up. You haven't got to see that.
No. I'm going to have a little clear up. You won't see that.
And while we're having a little clear up...
No, while I'm having a little clear up...
You've made your point, Sharon.
Well, stop saying we, because it's only I.
Right, well, we're going to have a little clear up. I'm going to say that again, because I will help you.
Aye.
Can we stop now? Because I'll cut all that out anyway. You keep saying I after I say we, I'm going to just cut that out.
Hello.
You're going to have a little clear up.
Thank you.
And I'm going to, I forgot what I was going to say now, look. And then afterwards we're going to do the actual blancmange mix, so while we wait.
And I will let him make the blancmange.
While we're waiting for the sponge to cool down. All right then, baby, you can do the camera work and the editing. See you later. Right, this actually took 25 minutes now. It's come out now, let's show you.
So there's the sponge. You might see the little hole there we poked in there, folks. That's where we stuck a skewer just to check whether or not the mixture was actually cooked or not.
We're going to just put this to one side now, and we are going to make the pink custard, baby. Is that right? Right, so we've got the box here. We're just going to copy the ingredients off the box here. You might as well. There's no rocket science here. Right, so we're going to incorporate the milk and our pink custard, which is blancmange mix.
Right, so we're just going to take the contents of the sachet, empty it into a bowl, and then we're just going to take a little drop of our milk, 3 tablespoons there, and we're just going to add that to the powder just so that we can mix up and make a paste. I'm just going to empty the contents of the milk into a saucepan ready to heat up.
I'm just going to warm the milk up. Right, so we've got a little drop of the warm milk now, and you're just going to tip a little drop of that into our mixture.
Right, okay then, so we're going to just now add the rest of the warm milk to the blancmange mix. Just give it a good old stir. We don't want no lumps in there. And then we're going to transfer this back into the saucepan and take it over to our cooker and just simmer it until we get a nice little simmer.
Right, so we're just, while we're letting that warm up for a little bit, we're just gonna turn out the cake now, or the sponge mix. Right, hopefully, oh, Sharon. Oh, that's perfect, look at that flat bottom you've got on that, look. That's definitely the way to do it, isn't it? Fantastic. This is the way we're gonna cover it now. We're gonna leave it this way up, and we're gonna cover this with the strawberry jam, and then also sprinkle the coconut, and then we're gonna cut it into sections, just like you remember from the school days.
Right, so this is Sharon's homemade jam, believe it or not. Look how lumpy that is, look. Pure strawberries in that. Look, she made that herself. What a clever little girl. So she's just spreading it over the top there of the sponge.
just getting all the lumps evenly, and then she's just delicately dressing the top of that jam sponge with desiccated coconut. Look at that, just like school dinners. Remember that, folks. And don't forget, this was a tray bake, and you used to get this served up in squares, just like this.
Oh, look at that. Take a nice bit, love. Right, place that in our little bowl. Eh?
How big is that?
Oh, that's superb. Look at that. Let's go and get some custard right now. The old pink custard's ready. Oh, look at that. Let's have a closer look at that. We've done another one. We've recreated another classic vintage retro recipe. And this one should take you right back to before you knew me. Shall I have a go, or you want to go first?
You go first.
Here we go. Oh, that custard's hot.
That's the idea of it.
I want to get a nice bit of that custard, look. Love I've got for this is like the love I've got for you, baby.
Don't choke. Don't talk with your mouth full.
Oh. Oh.
Stop it.
Yes, miss. Going back to the 70s. Oh, let's have another go. I've got all like pitch like I used to talk, baby, when I was about 12 years old. Oh. Oh.
Well, here we go.
No.
Oh, he's controlling himself.
Oh. Woo. God, that is a time warp, baby. You have a go. See if it does the same to you.
It won't do the same to me.
Go on. Superb. Just like school dinners used to be. Go on. Mm. Hey? Is it good?
I'd actually prefer it like that.
So we've got to go now because I'm putting her on detention. See you later, folks. Don't forget to rate, comment and subscribe. We love seeing your comments. And if you've got any suggestions of stuff you want to see us make, got to be vintage, got to be retro, we'll have a go at it. So leave it in the comment section below. See you later, folks.
Bye.
Pink custard, you can't beat it.